Hi, my name is Anmol. I'm a graduate of the Human Dynamics group here at the Media Lab. And we're going to talk about the work I did while I was here and also about the startup that ended up spinning out of this group. So quick history. So I finished my PhD, and I'll talk about some of the projects here. And then some of the work I did for my PhD led us to start Change.io, which today is a commercial platform deployed with over a dozen big hospital systems across the US as we help them manage their patient populations. Most of the work that I was doing while at the Media Lab in the Human Dynamics group was around modeling human behavior using mobile phone sensors. And so everybody's carrying one of these devices, and they're incredibly powerful diaries of a person's life because they have location sensors and calling and texting and accelerometers and all sorts of other data. And one of the studies that we talk about here was at a dorm at MIT, where we had undergraduate students, an entire community, using these mobile phones for about a year, and we understood patterns of diffusion in their behavior. We had several interesting findings from that study. So one direction was just looking at things related to their political opinion. So this was during the US presidential campaigns, looking at patterns of exposure amongst students who were leaning Democrat versus Republican, and figuring out dynamic sort of patterns of homophily that emerge around political events in that period, and also using unsupervised methods to see what characterizes a certain kind of voter from another in terms of their behaviors. Another category of work was around looking at eating and exercise and diet and other habits and how they spread through this tight-knit community during the course of that period. And what we found was mobile phones and the data that you can collect allows you to build really fine-grained models of exposure for particular individuals and the exposure they have to people who perhaps exercise the same or eat healthier or don't eat healthier. We found that one of the most important factors in predicting weight gain during the semester, during the school year, was exposure to other people who gained weight in the same period. So not so much exposure to people who were eating unhealthy or not exercising to begin with, but people who are going through that same transition in that period. And the goal of that particular study was to highlight the differences between different causal mechanisms that might explain that behavior change. So differentiating homophily from influence or confounding factors. And then the work that sort of really led us to start the company was around what happens to a person's behavior when they're symptomatic. And so we were looking at mental health and influenza and common colds. And turns out that there are significant changes in behavior for people when they're symptomatic. And these changes are quite intuitive. So if you think of what happens when a person has influenza, they're probably sitting at home and they can't go to school and they can't go to work. Or if you look at the clinical markers for major depressive disorder, which talks about how people isolate themselves when they have a flare-up of their depressive episodes, or the clinical markers for bipolar disorder, turns out you can actually detect those behavior changes just using their mobile phone data. And we were able to use that information and identify with reasonably high accuracy which days people are likely to be symptomatic. So in this particular study, we were able to identify 60 to 90% of the days that people were likely to be symptomatic just based on how they were behaving using their mobile phone data. So that was sort of an interesting finding and led us to go off and start Change.io, which is now a company that's actually commercializing that platform. What we do at Change.io is solve a very fundamental problem for hospitals, which is if you're a big hospital system and you have tens of thousands of patients, how do you know which of your patients need help today or this week? And there's really no way of capturing that data because you can't get those people to fill out surveys or do other things. And so now we can automate that process of managing a patient population. So hospitals now get patients to install the Change.io app, which is a commercial version of some of the work that we were doing here. And this app collects a variety of data, and then we use that to understand what's the behavior change for certain kinds of symptomatic days for these patient populations and predict those behavior changes. This is what the mobile app looks like today now that it's a commercial platform. So you can send people questions and you can automate sending them reminders and insights and tips based on how they're behaving. So if, for example, if somebody is at risk of a certain condition and they haven't been getting a lot of sleep, you can actually detect that and send them reminders to go off and better manage their condition. this is an example of what the interface looks like from the nurse's office or the doctor's office. So they have a large group of patients that they're managing, and we help them. We give them essentially an indicator, we call it the check engine light, for which of their patients need help. And the same information is also shared with family members or friends that a person may nominate as part of this process, where they want their health alert shared with that person. And the company has been around for about 2 years since we spun out of the group here. We've had about $500,000 in prize money. We've been covered in a variety of different sort of media sources. And then we've raised about $8.5 million in venture financing, and there's an incredibly strong team that now is building a commercial version of the work that was done here at the Media Lab. So, cool. Thank you.